Hey guys, this is Clinton Jeff, and today we're checking out the upcoming new Adidas X9000 L4 shoes. The Adidas X9000 L4 is a brand new silhouette that should be dropping anytime now. This is part of a series of shoes, and there's cheaper options with less boost in the midsole. There's the Adidas X9000 L1, which is the cheapest and features an algae-based sock liner with Adidas Bounce midsole cushioning. Then there's the slightly more expensive X9000 L2, which features a more comfortable textile upper with the same algae-based EVA foam and Adidas Bounce midsole cushioning. Next in the series is the X9000 L3, which has boost cushioning but only in the forefoot area. There's a slightly more comfortable upper and a special outsole tread pattern that is apparently inspired by computer generated data to provide reliable traction on city streets. Or at least that's what Adidas says. And then lastly, there's this, the X9000 L4, which has everything the L3 model has, but with an even more comfortable mesh upper, a full-length boost midsole, and that same computer-generated data-inspired outsole tread pattern. So yeah, here we are. Honorable mention, of course, there's also a 4D version called the Adidas X9000 4D, because apparently Adidas is really obsessed with making 4D versions of every one of their shoes this year. Coming to the L4 itself, you can see that I got the iridescent launch colorway, which is similar to the colorway that the Ultraboost 20 ISS collab dropped in. But the shoe will also come in a whole bunch of colorways at launch. There's an all-black version, a grey and neon green version, and a couple other colorways as well. The silhouette of the L4 definitely borrows from silhouettes of the past. It's a really sleek, streamlined design that you have to admit looks pretty futuristic. Starting with the upper, it's a sock-like construction that is made out of a black Adidas primeknit material, which is extremely breathable. Then there's also this geometric taping-like floating triangular tonal accents and supportive underlays to add more structure to the upper, but also adds a distinctive design to the shoe. And if all of that wasn't enough, there's also a lot of shimmering purple accents all around. There's a lot going on with this upper. The medial and lateral sides of the shoe look pretty much the same, with the Adidas 3 stripes on the side that have this interesting fingerprint waves-like finish, which looks pretty cool but sadly is not reflective. And moving towards the back, you have this interesting but admittedly kind of weird, sparkly plastic oversized heel counter that extends around the back of the heel. This area with that pull tab kind of thing at the back feels very similar to the Ultra Boost. At the top of the shoe is this trail shoe inspired lacing system here that adds a rugged utilitarian design to the shoe. Then there's this interesting pop of a baby blue color on the first two lace eyelets, which is kind of fun. The flat black laces weave through these eyelets and feel comfortable enough on your feet. Although there's something about this area that you should know, which I'll mention when we talk about comfort later on. Apart from that, moving upwards, there's the Adidas 3-stripe performance logo at the top of the tongue in a lime green color. Of course, since this is a one-piece booty construction, there's no actual tongue here. Coming to the inside of the shoe, you have a black insole with the Boost logo in this neon red color. And then moving downwards, let's talk about the most interesting part of the shoe. The part that will literally steal your focus when you glance upon these for the first time. At the bottom is a huge exaggerated Boost midsole that seems to be separated in various sections, but only by design. There are sections with that iridescent purple separated by these black Boost sections, which all end up making the shoe look really aggressive. The extra chunky midsole design seems to be inspired by the Oswego, the Adidas Lexicon, and maybe even the Adidas Crazy Boost You wear shoes. Whatever was the inspiration, it is definitely appreciated, because that extra chunky Boost midsole coupled with that mesh upper makes this one of the most comfortable Boost shoes that I've tried on in a while. Moving on, you'll notice that the midsole at the forefoot is lined with this lime green rubber outsole, which adds to the ultra futuristic look and has a nice pop of color as people see you walking around on these. The rest of the outsole seems to be your usual black rubber Adidas outsole. Unfortunately, no Continental rubber here. One thing that I did notice were these tiny rubber spikes on the outsole, which is supposed to be for added traction, but these tend to get worn out pretty quickly the more you wear the shoe. That's about it for design, let's move on to performance. Now this shoe is supposed to be a casual running shoe. That's because the X9000 L1, the L2 and the L3 are all kind of serious running shoes. But let's be real guys, this is a casual lifestyle shoe. Could you actually use these for running? Well, yeah, you totally could. As I mentioned earlier, the outsole tread pattern was inspired by computer generated data and is supposed to provide reliable traction on city streets. From my experience with these shoes, that seems to be true. The shoe holds up pretty well on city runs, on streets and roads, and seems to have plenty of traction. The traction held up pretty well even on a rainy run on a wet road. But then again, I'm a really casual runner, so take that advice for what you think it's worth. That being said, obviously this isn't as grippy as the Continental rubber and the traction pattern on the Ultraboost line of shoes, but the Ultraboost also cost a lot more than the L4, so that's not a huge surprise. But all in all, it is a pretty comfortable running shoe, thanks to the oversized boots midsole and the super breathable mesh upper. Yet all of that being said, I still think these are more better suited as comfortable lifestyle everyday shoes. As a running shoe, it's comfortable if you really want something plush, but it's quite heavy. I think Adidas is positioning these as running shoes the same way they tried to position Ultraboost as running shoes. But as you know, everybody ends up wearing the Ultraboost as everyday lifestyle shoes. That's about it for performance. Let's talk about comfort and fit. You guys probably know by now that I'm probably one of the biggest Boost fans out there. It's by far one of the most comfortable cushioning tech out there right now. Honestly, if you haven't tried on a pair of Boost shoes yet, you are definitely missing out. I definitely encourage you to head on over to an Adidas store and try one out. Maybe if it ever gets safe to go out again. Adidas has managed to achieve cushioning that is just the right amount of plush but reactive at the same time. This is why a lot of people think that Boosts are some of the most comfortable shoes on the market for years now, because they're just great everyday lifestyle shoes. I know I've said those words a lot of times in this video, but it's definitely true. It just feels great underfoot with that bouncy plush feeling. But here's the thing, all of that being said, there's something you should know. These shoes have one very annoying flaw, which makes them really annoying to wear. I would say uncomfortable, but it's not really uncomfortable, it's just annoying. The little black triangle overlay here lies right on top of your little toe, and boy is it annoying. You can literally feel it brush up against your little toe with every step, which is just really, really annoying. And then adding to that annoyance is the fact that you can actually feel the hard reinforced areas of the lowest top two sets of lace eyelets pushing down on the top of your feet. Now, admittedly, both of these issues would be fixed by wearing thicker socks instead of the slim no-show socks I usually wear, but geez, this was a total bummer. Now I know what you're thinking, could this be a fit issue? In terms of fit, these fit pretty much true to size, but if you have wide feet like I do, you might want to go up half a size or up even a full size. I'm a UK 11, but I went up a full size to a UK 12 here, which fits great except for that little annoyance that I mentioned earlier. Alright guys, with all that out of the way, let's take a look at the Adidas X9000 L4 on feet. The Adidas X9000 L4 will be priced at $150 in the US, unless they change something up before they drop. That makes them quite a bit cheaper than the Ultraboost, but the same price as the awesome new ZX2K shoe, which is as attractive but even more comfortable. If you want to check out the ZX2K, I'll leave a link to my review in the description below. Out of the two of these, personally, I would go with the ZX2K. It's just a more comfortable shoe all around. All in all, the Adidas X9000 L4 is a pretty comfortable shoe if you get the sizing right and you don't mind the annoyances that I talked about. I honestly can't take it seriously as a running shoe, but if you really want a nice, comfortable, chunky running shoe, well, here you go. But personally, I'm looking at the Adidas X9000 L4 as a really slick, futuristic looking, chunky and comfortable everyday lifestyle shoe. It's a weird model name, but it's totally worth checking out. Just maybe try them on in a store first, just so you know if that triangle is actually annoying to you or not. Alright guys, so that's what I think about the brand new upcoming Adidas X9000 L4 shoes. If you have any questions about these shoes, you can let me know right in the comment section below. Otherwise, if you want to see more photos of the shoe, you can hit me up on Instagram and maybe give me a follow at Clinton Jeff. And if you found this video helpful and you want to support the channel, don't forget to hit the like button right below and maybe subscribe, because that would be appreciated. And yeah, that's about it. Thanks for watching guys, and I'll catch you in the next one.